Pakistan, treasure highland for the smart investor. Pakistan, a land of many splendors and opportunities, a unique blend of history and culture from the east and the west. The cradle of an ancient civilization which developed around the Indus Valley, with one of the highest peaks of the world in the north and the vast plains in the south. Strategically situated, Pakistan is an ideal destination for foreign investment. Nestled between South Asia and the Middle East, with a large coastline along the Arabian Sea, Pakistan is geostrategically positioned as a gateway to the energy-rich but capital-intensive Central Asian states, China, and the Far Eastern markets. Realizing this potential, the government is implementing a strategic approach on the National Trade Corridor, linking Pakistan's major ports in the south. Gwadar, located on the southwestern coast of Pakistan, is all set to become a hub of shipping, commercial and industrial activities. With a population of 160 million people, the country offers both a lucrative consumer market as well as a well-trained and competent workforce. The demographic dividend can fuel Pakistan's growth for the next 50 years. Add to that a business-friendly environment, robust economic indicators, untapped investment opportunities, and a growing world-class infrastructure. It is no wonder that Pakistan is one of the fastest-growing emerging economies in the world today.
Pakistan is a country with rich potentials in agriculture and natural resources. It is the fifth largest milk-producing country in the world. The textile industry of Pakistan is ranked 10th in the world textile trade. And Pakistan has the third largest coal deposits in the world. Pakistan today provides one of the cheapest yet productive labor force in the world. These are the opportunities waiting to be explored by both foreign and local investors.
The World Bank, in its Ease of Doing Business Report 2008, has ranked Pakistan higher than its contemporary regional competitors.
Metro Cash and Carry Pakistan opened the first outlet in Lahore, the second one in Islamabad. We will open several other, at least 10 stores in this country, investing more than 200 million euro. We have a great answer, a response from the people, from the government. The economy is growing very fast. We want to participate in this growth of economy because the country is very dynamic.
The Pakistan market has delivered a truly outstanding performance in recent years. Pakistan market is trading at a price earnings multiple of around 12 times on 2009 earnings, making it one of the cheapest markets in Asia. This is because the run-up in the market has been supported by very strong GDP growth rates in excess of 7% per annum over the last 5 years and very strong corporate profitability rates.
Substantial investment is being made to meet the ever-growing energy needs of the country, with a focus on tapping its huge hydrocarbon potential. The private sector is in process of boosting energy production in the country through investments in oil and gas exploration, refineries, and independent power plants. The discovery of huge coal deposits of 175.5 billion tons in the area of Tarpatgarh in Sindh has provided a quantum increase in the coal resources of Pakistan. The success rate for drilling activities is one of the highest in the world.
Shell has been in Pakistan for over 100 years, and Pakistan remains a very important country to the Shell Group. With over 160 million people, the country offers huge opportunities on all fronts. In the energy sector, demand is expected to more than double in the next 10 to 15 years. This provides opportunities in the area of exploration, in the development of alternate energy, in the power sector, and in all other facets of the energy industry. What makes Pakistan stand out is its immense talent pool. This is a big plus factor for all investors.
The Pakistani economy's stellar performance has not gone unnoticed. Foreign investment has crossed a record $8.4 billion during the fiscal year of 2007 alone. Pakistan re-entered the international capital market in 2004 after the lapse of 6 years, and since then has issued 4 international bonds, all of which were heavily oversubscribed, an indicator of the international investors' confidence in Pakistan's economy.
Tisian is a gold and copper mining company that is co-owned by Antofagasta Minerals, a large Chilean copper company, and Barrick Gold, which is the largest gold mining company in the world. It is currently developing a gold and copper mine in Balochistan, which lies along the Tisian Belt, that is a region of gold and copper resource that begins in Central Asia and extends all the way through to Mongolia and Southeast Asia. The least developed part of this is here in Pakistan. We are not only developing a gold and copper mine, but we are actually undertaking the largest industrial investment ever undertaken in the history of Pakistan.
A key driver of Pakistan's economic growth has been its well-developed banking and financial sector. Financial sector reforms, along with the robust economy, have made Pakistani banks amongst the most profitable in the region. The recent acquisitions of Union Bank by Standard Chartered, Saudi Bank Bank by a consortium including Bank Muscat and Japan's Nomura International are evidence of the bright prospects within the financial sector. Malaysian Bank, Malaysia's largest lender, recently acquired a 15% strategic stake in MCB Bank for over $650 million. Barclays Bank recently acquired a local banking license, whilst the Royal Bank of Scotland have announced the rebranding to the RBS brand for all local branches of the recently acquired ABN AMRO Bank. Acquisitions of Laxam Tobacco by Philip Morris, WorldCall Telecom by Omantel, and Pakistan Cement Company by Lafarge highlight the potential of other sectors as well.
Pakistan has one of the biggest fertilizer industries in the world with more than 6 million tons of installed capacity. In addition, there are expansions underway right now which will add another 2 million tons or a little bit more than that to our capacity. This includes the world's biggest single train urea plant ever set up anywhere in the world. Similarly, in milk, we are one of the biggest milk producers in the world. And with the changes happening in the global economy as subsidies come down in the developed world, there is a possibility for Pakistan to position itself to become one of the major suppliers of milk products, not just in the region, but also for the global market.
The mainstay of the economy still remains the agriculture sector that accounts for 20% of GDP, employing 43% of the workforce, and offers lucrative opportunities in terms of value-added products in dairy and horticultural segments. Our investment policy allows 100% foreign equity in corporate agriculture farming projects.
We are a farm service company providing inputs and services to the farmers. Pakistan holds a tremendous potential in the development of the agriculture sector. We have 1,500 miles of alluvial soils around the Indus Basin. We have 4 distinct seasons. We grow just about any crop under the sun. And as we now modernize this vital sector, the commercial opportunities for companies to come and participate in this modernization are endless.
Deregulation and privatization have been the main drivers of the spectacular growth in the telecom sector in the recent past. Telecom penetration has jumped from barely 3% to an astonishing 58% following deregulation, liberalization, and privatization. The state-owned telco, PTCL, was acquired by Etisalat of the UAE, and other major international players have entered the market, including Telenor, Singtel, and the world's largest mobile phone operator, China Mobile, which made its first foray into the international market by purchasing a cellular operator in Pakistan. The world's first WiMAX network has been established in Pakistan by Vateen Telecom, who have successfully launched WiMAX nationwide. hence introducing next generation technology with a cutting edge in communications infrastructure.
China Mobile has also chosen Pakistan as the first market to roll out its global brand zone, and we have acquired 1 million new subscribers in less than 1 month after the launch of Zone.
To make up for the housing backlog and shortfall, production of housing is to be raised to 800,000 units annually. Leading construction firms, including Emaar and Al Ghurair Giga of the UAE and Bach Gulf Construction of Saudi Arabia, have already initiated their multi-billion dollar projects in Pakistan. The automobile sector has received a particular focus by the government, and that is why deletion programs in 2005 were replaced with a tariff-based system.
Atlas Group has had a unique strategy to enter into joint ventures with various multinationals, specifically in two areas. One is the automobile sector and the other is power. In the automobile sector, Atlas has been a joint venture partner of Honda for the last 45 years. During this process, we've gone from selling around 600 motorcycles a year to this year 460,000 motorcycles a year. Similarly, in cars, the joint venture this year will be aiming to produce over 20,000 cars a year.
With a diverse topography, Pakistan is a tourist's heaven. From sandy beaches to icy tops, rugged terrains and deserts to green plateau, it's all here. Whether it's history or culture, the many cultures of Pakistan are an enticing opportunity for investment in tourism, especially after declaration of tourism as an industry. Hotels and other tourism projects hold great promise and rewards for the investors. On a firm footing towards economic prosperity, Pakistan offers you to join it on its journey towards economic progress. Come and find out why Pakistan is a treasure highland for the smart investor.